Welcome to the KOSTAL service video on how to undertake the initial commissioning of the Plenticore Plus, Plenticore BI, and Pico IQ. Please note the information relating to proper use. All inverters have a control panel with navigation keys below the display. Characters, buttons, functions, and input fields are selected with the arrow keys. Two LEDs below the control panel indicate the current operational status of the device. The display can be used to enter text and numbers, e.g. inverter name. If input is required, a keypad of letters and numbers appears under the input box. First, switch on the grid voltage via the line circuit breaker. The device software launches. Turn the DC switch to the on position. The entire commissioning process can be undertaken via the display. Follow the instructions in the display. The commissioning wizard will launch with the welcome screen. Press the right arrow key to start the installation. The language menu is displayed. Select the desired language and confirm with Enter. Press the right arrow key to go to the next element of installation. The date and time menu is displayed. If the inverter is already connected to the local network, the date and time are determined automatically via the preset NTP server. Select the relevant time zone and set the date and time. Confirm with Enter and press the right arrow key to go to the next element of installation. The Energy Management menu is displayed. You can place a limit on the maximum grid feed-in here. In Germany, for example, this may be 70% of the connected PV generator capacity. To do this, press Enter and use the arrow keys to enter the value you want. Confirm each digit with Enter. Once all digits have been entered, confirm by selecting the tick symbol. Use the arrow keys to select the energy meter field and press Enter. Now you can select the energy meter fitted from the list and confirm with Enter. Note: to run a battery on the Plenticore Plus and the Plenticore BI, you will need to use an energy meter. Use the arrow keys to select the sensor position field and press Enter. Now select the position of the energy meter fitted and confirm with Enter. Press the right arrow key to go to the next element of installation. The network IPv4 menu is displayed. Press Enter to activate the IPv4 DHCP network protocol. You can configure the network settings in this menu. When the product is supplied, the IP address is automatically obtained from a local router in the local network via DHCP. Switch to manual and enter the IP settings you want. Confirm the input with Enter. Press the right arrow key to go to the next element of installation. The Modbus SunSpec TCP menu is displayed. If you require Modbus TCP for external connected monitoring of the inverter, for example, you can activate it here. To activate Modbus TCP, press Enter. Press the right arrow key to go to the next element of installation. The Solar Portal menu appears in the display. Select the corresponding menu item with the arrow keys. We recommend always activating the Solar Portal. Confirm the input with Enter. To activate the transfer, highlight the item and confirm with the Enter key. Press the right arrow key to go to the next installation. The Extra Options menu appears on the display. This element can be used to release options by entering an activation code on the inverter. Select Release option and confirm the input with the Enter key. Note: for the Plenticore Plus, you can get an activation code for connecting a battery to DC input 3 on the inverter from the KOSTAL online shop. Enter the activation code you obtained previously from the KOSTAL Solar online shop. Once the code has been entered, confirm by selecting the tick symbol. Press the right arrow key to go to the next element of installation. If you have entered a battery activation code, you can now select the battery type used. Use the arrow keys to select the battery type. Confirm the input with Enter. Press the right arrow key to go to the next element of installation. The Country Guideline menu appears in the display. Ask your grid operator which guideline you need to set. Select the country or required grid line and confirm the input with Enter. Press the right arrow key to go to the next installation item. Accept Settings appears in the display. Press Enter to confirm the input. The settings are applied by the inverter. Once the commissioning wizard has finished, the inverter restarts. The initial commissioning process is then complete, and the device is ready. Using the display, you can now view the inverter's operating values. Use the arrow and acknowledgement keys on the control panel to navigate. The inverter provides various menu items for status queries and configuration. The user interface and menu entries in the inverter depend on the installed firmware and the user interface software in the inverter. When no key has been pressed for several minutes, the screensaver with the image of the inverter appears automatically on the display. Pressing any key activates the background lighting. You can exit the screensaver again by pressing any key. You can use the Settings menu to change the most important settings later on. If an incorrect country setting has been selected by mistake, this can be changed in the service menu by going to Reset National Guideline. To do this, use the arrow keys to switch to the inverter symbol and confirm with Enter. Note: the Reset National Guideline choice only appears once a service code has been entered. You can request the service code in the service area on the KOSTAL website. Please also watch our videos about web servers for the PIKO IQ, PLENTICORE Plus, and PLENTICORE BI.